What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about using Nick Teaming within Windows Server. It's actually configuring it, so let's get right into it. Now, I have a virtual machine within my infrastructure with two virtual network cards. It's right here. I want to actually team these guys as one, and this is how we do it. So on the desktop, we are going to click on Start. We're going to click on Server Manager. And once Server Manager is up and running, we're going to click on Local Server. And within the properties, we're going to locate Nick Teaming. Now, by default, it is disabled, but that word disabled is actually a hyperlink. So if we click on that, it loads this nice Nick Teaming dialog box. From here, the section where it says Teams, there's a drop-down or a task menu. So if we click on Task, it gives you a menu. And that's the option that we want. We are going to click on New Team. You're going to get this nice little dialog box. We're going to provide our team a name. I gave it the following. We're going to select our virtual network cards. And again, I'm doing everything within a virtual machine. So within a virtual machine and a physical machine, something's going to happen. I'm going to show you what happens within the virtual environment. So we're going to select both of our virtual network cards. And I'm going to click on additional properties, that little arrow to expand it. Awesome. And by default, these are all the settings that it gives you. All right. You are able to just click on OK to continue. Now, check this out. If you click on OK with the current settings within a virtual environment, it's going to give you this. Within the virtual environment, it does not like these settings. So that means we need to change it. And if you kind of highlight that red, it gives you the following. Again, it does not, the virtual environment does not like these settings. So now to change it, load balancing mode by default is dynamic. So if you click on the drop-down menu, we're going to select address hash. All right, within the virtual environment, it likes this option. Dynamic will only work within a physical server. So now that we changed the load balancing mode to address hash within a virtual environment, we're able to click on OK. It's going to start saving. And then if everything works well, you're going to get this. Now, both network cards will go down temporarily, so don't freak out. But within the adapters and interfaces, you're going to see that it's pending. Eventually, if everything works well, both of them should go up, a green arrow up and then active, and that's it. If you go back inside the network connections, you're going to see a new icon and whatever name you gave your team, you're going to see it here. And then that's it. Awesome. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.